I welcome you all with my love and respects. Let's enter into today's sutras, today's aphorisms. Tada drashtuh swarupe vastanam means when withdrawal from mental patterns happens, when you take the responsibility for your mind, remembering you are thinking. Thinking is your action. It is not, mind is not an object or it is not a thing. It is your very action. The moment you take the responsibility, the moment you start remembering that, mind is an action. Suddenly you will see you are able to stop when you don't want, you are able to operate when you want. Having that freedom, having that liberation is what Patanjali calls swarupe vastanam, means establishing in your own nature. Please understand, we need to understand the word nature. It's an important understanding. Usually, what we call as nature is the state which is confused, deluded, depressed. We start calling this as our nature. Where Patanjali says, swarupe, nature means complete, settled, pure consciousness. He doesn't say our deluded state as nature. Usually, when we talk or think or anyway, anytime, when we use the word our nature, we start using the meaning of our nature, what we call or what we think as our nature. That is a big problem. Patanjali says, nature means in the state where there is no thoughts. When the chitta vritti nirodha, when chitta vritti nirodha happens, that is what is our state. Superficially, when you look at the sutras, Patanjali looks like a scientist, straight. He is not lost in poetry. You can see there is no poetical words here. There is no poetry. Being an enlightened master, talking in a simple, straight prose is very difficult. Because in enlightenment, you are lost in ecstasy. You are lost in ecstasy. And talking in a simple prose words seems to be abnormal, seems to be too rude, too violent. But here, if you look a little deep, you will understand the tremendous compassion of Patanjali. The Patanjali's compassion, the very stand he takes. He is not interested in agreeing with what you call as nature, with what you call as standard. From the very step, he is very clear about what is our nature. One more beautiful thing. First, he gives the truth. As I was telling yesterday, that 33%, the first 33% waiting for the click, just express the truth, they will have the connection. The second 33% needs little conviction, little convincing, little one or two techniques. The third 33, very difficult to handle. He is slowly touching one by one through these first three sutras. He is trying to give the click, straight click to the first 33% who are waiting for the truth, who are just waiting for the click to happen. He is giving them chance. So in these three sutras, the whole thing he completes. Whatever he is going to tell, the essence of everything, he completes in these three sutras. All you need to understand is understanding this one thing. Mind is not a thing, it is your action. Just like you can stop walking, standing, sitting, you can stop the mind because it is an action. This one understanding is enough. Nothing else is needed. You are a yogi now. You are a yogi. But he is straight away telling in one word, mind is not a thing, it is an action, just stop, you are a yogi. So when you have all these questions, any one of these questions, now you are second 33%. Yeah, second 33%. Now Patanjali is talking to you. The next step he is taking. He started using the regular, the words of a teacher, a lecturer. First three sutras, he is like a master, straight, Zen master. Now he is going to the second tone. He starts explaining one by one. This is what, this is what, this is what. He is using more word. I can say, he is a little compassionate, he is not ready to leave us. After some time, after this chapter, he is handling the third category. You should see the tremendous patience, amazing patience, explaining every inch. Actually, first when I read the Yoga Sutras, I thought, how can an enlightened master be so dry? Because he is not making any jokes, stories or poetry, nothing. Straight away he is talking like an angry husband. And not a single extra word. Nothing. Straight. He is saying tuck, 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 tuck. Now I understand. First he is trying to deal with the people who are waiting for the click. Who have experienced that now. Ata yoganu sasanam. Who are ready. Who are in this moment to receive yoga. Who are ready for yoga. Who are ready to explode. So he is trying to handle them. They are waiting. He can't delay the process. He can't make them wait more and more. So he is straight away delivering for them. Once he is finished with them, then he goes to second 33%. There he is little more relaxed. He is using extra words. He is not poetic, but at least using extra words to convince. In the third, when he is touching the third 33%, there he is very poetic.
Paramahamsa Nityananda conducts Inner Awakening, a 21-day enlightenment intensive course, and Life Bliss Engineering, a 3-month course for having a yogic body and Vedic mind. Call 919731257960, 919742203311.